Banks will soon be forced to be more upfront with customers, while regional banks could be given extra powers to help them compete against the majors. It's part of a range of measures announced by the government to ensure better transparency between companies and customers.
It's the time-consuming chore, often filled with confusing jargon and volumes of paperwork. Labor has announced a raft of new changes to ensure Australians start getting a fair go at the bank.
This is all about better information, better disclosure, and making it easier for people to find better accounts and better mortgages. It's all about making it easier for Australians to find and follow better deals.
Under the new proposal, companies will be required to notify their customers of when their interest rate changes on either transaction or saving accounts. Banks will also be compelled to offer simpler mortgage paperwork and upfront details about deposit products.
I think there's a broad acknowledgement and acceptance following the great work of the ACCC and the Parliamentary Committee that we can do better here, and we will. And that's what these changes are about. We will work with the banks and with the community more broadly to bed them down.
It follows two separate inquiries by the competition watchdog to ensure customers get the best deal for them and to improve their experience at the teller.
I think we've struck the right balance here. Obviously, we took into consideration all of the ACCC recommendations, and we prioritised the ones that we thought were the most important, and you're seeing that in this package today. You know, this is not necessarily the end of the changes that we want to make life a bit easier for people in the banking system, but it's an important set of steps that we are taking, initial set of steps responding to that good work by the ACCC and by Daniel Molino's committee.
New data from the Australian National University shows households with a mortgage suffered a 26% increase in living costs since the pandemic. That's compared with 18% for renters.
And obviously there is work that can be done here by the banks, particularly on deposits. Australians have already been switching quite heavily in terms of their mortgage rates. So I think this will help. But by the same token, we don't want to kid ourselves. This is not a fundamental solution to the cost of living crisis in Australia.
It's unclear when the proposed reforms will be implemented. The Treasurer insists the finer details are still being looked into.